Joining me now in the studio is Selim Atalay, journalist and commentator for 24 TV here in Istanbul. Hi, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
When you read the New York Times piece, I mean, it all makes sense. It's all logical, and President Donald Trump obviously agreed. So why is John Bolton in particular on another page entirely?
Right now, he's being asked the same question in Ankara facing Turkish officials. It's not hard to guess. And also, it's quite rare that Monday's Washington Post had the headline, Bolton contradicts Trump on Syria. You don't get these headlines that often. I mean, I know Bolton likes getting on the front page, but probably this
right.
is not
Right, not his. In a way that might get him fired.
Exactly.
Yeah.
In terms of the plan, this is the only plan that's been tabled. The U.S. would have been expected to table this plan long time ago. Mm-hmm. Again, comes back to the question, does the U.S. or does Mr. Bolton have a plan on Syria? Apparently not. The only thing he knew was to send armaments, weapons to certain terror groups and beef up the territory with weapons. This is the only plan that is available. It can be contributed, it can be expanded, but this is a plan that, which says there are other communities in northern Syria, not only the terror group affiliated, there are other groups, so
right.
there is a choice, there is a solution.
But when you see, you know, particularly yesterday, John Bolton standing side by side with Benjamin Netanyahu suddenly saying that there will be a more of a timetable for the withdrawal of U.S. troops, mm-hmm. and there is no time limit, completely contradicting Trump, yes. obviously. You have to think, is there a fear that they're not stating, especially on Israel's behalf, that the U.S. pulling out and the YPG, for as bad as they are better than allowing any sort of Iranian influence to flourish?
Again, were these the lines that were given to him in Washington? That is the question. Probably the divine atmosphere of Jerusalem just inspired Mr. Bolton with other things. And lines might have changed in Israel because of that. Just might be the atmosphere. But otherwise, this is not the stated line. This is not the stated policy by President Trump. Again, who is dictating the policies here is the question. Donald Trump says, get out, get fast, and I don't want to get involved anymore. Okay, Israel's security concerns. Israel, again, Donald Trump's words, is good. Israel is taking care of itself. Mm-hmm. Yes, Israel has been having a free hand in bombing whoever they want in Syria. And also, the striking point was the Netanyahu's claim on Golan Heights. Mm-hmm. That sets an interesting precedent. If Israel is grabbing part of Syria, where's Syria's territorial integrity in the U.S. plans? And if this sets a precedent, then where should Turkey grab?
Okay, let's just assume then somehow Turkey's plans go forward unabated.
Sure.
What will happen? How far into Syria will Turkey have to go? How much combat will have to be engaged in? And what will happen to refugees' families? I know that's a gigantic question, but give us an idea of how smoothly this could go if Turkey's plan.
Exactly. These are the things that need to be negotiated with the U.S. If the U.S. has real concerns about the future of Syria and stability, these are the things that should be negotiated. For instance, Turkey started with the U.S. military bases. The idea is either they hand it over to Turkey, again, some stabilization force as a force of stability, or destroyed, because those bases are a problem, and those bases were set up as if there would be no future withdrawal. They were just very permanent. Mm. That's number one. Number two, ISIS. President Erdogan explains there will be remnants. There will be groups who will act as or on behalf of ISIS, and there's no way to control them fully. But bombing them to Stone Age is not also a solution. Raqqa is the example. So these are the things that need to be negotiated, but the U.S. has no appetite. Even Mr. Bolton doesn't have an appetite for this because he's kept on saying we're not there for nation building, and
right.
that never works anyway.
Okay, Selim, we'll have to leave it there. Thanks so
Thank
much
you.
For joining us.